Hello, math students. This is Mr. Jacobs. We're looking at multiplying and dividing rational numbers. And we have an assignment on Big Ideas in Math, Course 2, Section 2.4. So let me zoom in and start off by looking at the first question. It says, how is multiplying and dividing rational numbers similar to multiplying and dividing integers? And the way you remember the rules for multiplying integers is that same signs return a positive answer, right? And we're looking at pairs of integers, and different signs return a negative number. So that's the same rule. Same rule for multiplying and dividing fractions or rational numbers. So the same rules for signs of integers apply to rational numbers. Okay? And if you don't recall what those were, if you were just to think about it this way, a negative number times a negative number, same signs, equals a positive answer. And a positive number times a positive number still equal a positive number. Those are same signs, see it? Well, that rule applies for fractions. Same thing for division. We're going to talk about division. A negative number divided by a negative number. It's a positive number. Positive number divided by a positive number. Positive number, same signs. So when you have different signs, you get the negative answer, okay? When you have different signs, you get a negative answer. And that looks something like this. Alrighty. It's true for integers and ratios of fractions. And remember, dividing is representative of what a fraction is, right? Numerator divided by denominator. Now, number two here. Two says, find the reciprocal of negative 2/5. So we just finished number one. Here's number two. Now, the reciprocal is, well, I'm not going to put that there. I'm just going to write this down. It's the same number, however, it has a it's flipped. Same ratio, you flip or switch the numerator and denominator. Why is that important? So if this is your original, this is your original, this is your reciprocal. Original, reciprocal. Why is that important? Well, it's because when you multiply by a reciprocal, you end up getting the identity, or one. So that would be this. So 2/5, the original fraction, multiplied by the reciprocal, 5/2, you end up with positive 10, right? Over positive 10, which is just 1. See how that works? You are multiplying straight across in this intermediate step that I didn't show. That step right there. You can do that in your head. It's just straight across, numerator, numerator, denominator, denominator. Same signs. 2 and 5 are both negative, positive 10. Same sign. 5 and 2 are both positive, positive 10. So my answer is negative 5 over 2. It says, tell whether the expression is negative or positive without doing the work. So do these have same signs? Are they both positive or negative? They're both negative, so the answer is going to be positive. You see that? Here, tell whether the expression is positive or negative without evaluating. So again, you have a positive number, it's a mixed number, divided by a negative number. Signs are different, so the answer is going to be what? Negative. So those two are examples. How you do the rest? Well, 5 and 6 and 7, I believe. So 3 is positive, 4 is negative. Without doing any of the work, just without evaluating. So now 7 says to multiply and write your answer as a simplest fraction. So this is a great question, because it's I don't know. Okay, we get so confused sometimes with these kinds of questions, but when you multiply negative 1 times 4/5, just want to point out that negative 1 is negative 1 over 1, right? And 4/5 is, of course, 4 over 5. And so when you multiply, this is the same sign. These are different signs, so it's going to be a negative answer. How do I know? Because negative 1 times negative 4 is going to be negative 4, and 1 times 5 is 5. So you end up with just negative 4 over 5. So look, you started off with this number, 4/5. You end up with this, negative 4/5. So just know that negative 1 takes any number when multiplied by negative 1 and just makes it its opposite. So since 4/5 is positive, it's now negative 4/5 since I multiplied by negative 1. Remember that. So all that work that I showed leads us to the rule that multiplying by 1 doesn't change the original number. Your original number is still 4/5, or any number for that matter. But the negative sign just gives you the opposite value that you originally had. In this case, we have positive 4/5. Now, the opposite of that is negative 4/5. So know that. So here, when you multiply by 1 again, doesn't change the answer. So my original value is negative 3.5. Multiplying by negative 1 gives me the opposite of that value, which is what? Positive 3.5. So the fraction in simplest form, I'm not sure if they're asking us to leave it as a mixed number, but I will and see if it's right or wrong. You guys tell me if it is or isn't. It would be just 3.5, right? You guys type that in yourselves. Here, you're multiplying by negative 1 again. Think about the original value is negative, what, 0.25? What's the opposite of a negative 0.25? Positive 0.25. All right, now here's, we got some keep, change, flip. Let's look at number 10. Number 10, negative 7 over 10 divided by 2 over 5. So I just want to let you know there's a way of doing this. It's called keep, change, flip. Keep the original. Change division to multiplication and take the reciprocal or flip. That's the pattern. So If I was going to work this out, it would be keep, change, flip. And the question is, why do we do that? And I'll explain why in just a bit. So it says negative 7 times 5 over 10 times 2, negative 35 over 20. Write fraction in simplest form. Well, I know that 5 goes into 20 and 35. How do I know that? Well, let's look at my multiplication chart. So if I look at the five list, I get 5, 10, 15, 20. There it is. 25, 30, 35. See it? 35 and 20 are in that row. 5 goes into 20 four times. Yep. It's 4 up here. See it? 4. 5 and 4. 5 times 4 is 20. And 5, 35, 5, and 35. That's 5 times 7. So 5 goes into 35 seven times. See it? Use your multiplication chart. So if you divide by 5, you end up with negative 7 over 4, and that's your reduced fraction. So why do we keep, change, flip? So I'm going to explain something to you that I figured out and studied mathematics. It's related to a fraction and its reciprocal. Pay attention. Don't miss this. But the original statement, negative 7 over 10 divided by 2 over 5, that can be written this way. Right? And I think that's called a compound fraction, where you have a fraction over a fraction. Okay? And so that's essentially what you see up there, the cube, change, flip. Well, it would be nice if you could get rid of a fraction in the denominator or numerator, right? Right. So let's get rid of the fraction in the denominator, because we know that if you could make this 1, right? If you could make this 1, then you know a number over 1 is just a number. Like, if I have a number like 5 over 1, you know that's just 5, right? So that's the strategy I'm going to be using. I want to just keep the numerator, 7 over 10. So we know that strategy. We just saw right now, a couple of slides ago, I'm almost done, that you can multiply by the reciprocal, and your fraction becomes 1. So do that. We also know that you can multiply the numerator by the reciprocal. Now you're thinking, well, we've never done that before. Yeah, we have. It's called the giant 1. I've written it this way, look. Remember this? If I just do it this way, the same number over the same number. That's 1, right? A fraction over the same fraction should be 1. Right? We've done that. That's my point. I said you could also write it this way. So take those numbers, write it as multiplying the numerator and denominator by the same value. It's still the giant 1, right? And so we do that. You see it. This becomes just 1. 10 over 10 is 1, right? This becomes negative 7. Here it is, look. Negative 7 times 5 over 10 times 2. That's the same expression we had here, see it? That becomes negative 35 over 20, which is all over 1. But we know that's just going to be 35 over 20. You see it? See, we have the same fraction. We reduce it, end up with negative 7 over 4. I think that's kind of neat, how you can use reciprocals to simplify complicated fractions, right? Fraction over a fraction. So that's how that works. So all of your questions here, 11, 12, 13, and 14, are all keep, change, flip, keep, change, flip. And we'll take a look at this again tomorrow. You guys practice them. See if you can figure out what to do and how to do it, okay? Good luck. Like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. See you soon. Bye-bye.